The Lakers look to make some changes after their first round exit in the playoffs this year to the Phoenix Suns. And Kyle Kuzma could be one of the ones that leaves as they try to rebuild the pieces around LeBron and AD to retool and try and get LeBron and the Lakers another title. In this video, we're going to be talking about some of the scenarios in which Kyle Kuzma could be traded, where and for what packages, and how likely I think it is that he is traded from the Los Angeles Lakers this summer. With that being said, if you guys like this type of NBA content, then consider subscribing and like the video if you do enjoy. And let's get right into it. Kyle Kuzma is one of the few players that survived the mass exodus of the Anthony Davis trade of all their young players that went over there. Of course, Lonzo Ball, Brandon Ingram, and Josh Hart, along with a boatload of picks he'd sent the other way. And Kuzma was seen, of course, as a lower value, but also a bit more as a complementary piece. Someone that might not have as high of a ceiling, but had an immediate impact on the team as soon as he came onto the team. Didn't necessarily have a higher ceiling, but had an ability to be able to fit into a championship team, at least so they thought, right away. And he has to an extent. Last year was definitely a better year for him than this season, in my opinion. He's averaged 12.8 and 12.9 points per game in the last 2 years, but those numbers this year are inflated from when he was starting with LeBron and AD and then out with injury. And so last year's numbers as a secondary guy was much more productive for him. His three-point efficiency went up drastically this year, though, up to 36%, the best of his career since his rookie season. And that was a big improvement for him and something that they need, as his off-ball shooting on a team with LeBron and his playmaking is very important. But his defense has been very hit and miss throughout his career, and that was no different this season. He has some times on the court where he just makes very poor decisions and just, it's almost just like he spaces out. Some games he's there, some games he isn't. He isn't overly consistent. And the Lakers need someone consistent that they can depend on as one of the third or fourth pieces on this team. And I think they're figuring out that maybe Kuzma isn't that guy. And maybe they want to package the likes of Kuzma and a pick, which they don't have many of. But what they could do is trade Kuzma and whoever they pick this year, and then trade him after the draft, or have a behind doors agreement and trade him along with this young player, something along those lines, to try and acquire a better third option for this LA Lakers team than Kyle Kuzma. Now, Kyle Kuzma's contract extension does kick in this upcoming season at $13 million a year for the next 3 years, and so they are going to be able to retain and take back some salary, which makes them, gives them some options to be able to make some trades here. Also note that Talen Horton-Tucker is also an RFA, and so he could also be used in some trade talks as someone who offers some significant value to other teams. Now, I don't think Kyle Kuzma goes to a great team. There's a reason why the Lakers want to trade him. I don't think any great teams are going to want him at $13 million, because ideally Kyle Kuzma is probably your fourth or fifth option on a really good team. And so I don't think he goes to a great team. And so one of the first options that I think we're going to be talking about is the Detroit Pistons. I think the Pistons are an interesting option, of course. The only person that they would really want on the Detroit Pistons roster is Jeremy Grant. Now, I don't know if Jeremy Grant has the type. I don't know if he's going to be too much for the Lakers, essentially. I don't know what the Pistons are going to value him at. I think his value at the trade deadline was much higher than it's going to be now. He only has 2 years left on his deal now instead of one. And his play in the second half of the season definitely was not as good in the first half as the league started to figure him out a bit more. Not sure the young guys in Detroit started to get the ball more as well, but I think the league kind of caught up to him a bit. And sure, Grant's good, but he's not a 20 point per game scorer on a good team. But he would be a very good third option for the LA Lakers, there's no doubt about it. We saw that in Denver when he was more of a secondary guy, and I think he would fit in great with the Lakers alongside Anthony Davis. Now, of course, Jeremy Grant is getting around the $20 million mark, and so they are going to have to add some salary to be able to bring him in from Detroit. One of the potential trade ideas could be Kyle Kuzma, Montrezl Harrell, and most likely whoever they take with their first round pick this year, maybe a second round pick as well, for the likes of Jeremy Grant. The Pistons are obviously going to want to get some value back for him. Jeremy Grant does not fit their timeline. He's going to be out of his current contract by the time the likes of Sadiq Bey and Killian Hayes and Isaiah Stewart, all these young players start to develop and become key players for the Detroit Pistons, for them to actually become a winning team. And so the fact that they could have potentially gotten a first and some quality at the deadline, they're probably going to regret not trading him then. But I wouldn't be shocked if they do look to get some value out of him this summer and try and add a piece like Kuzma, who fits the timeline a little bit better alongside the likes of Sadiq Bey and some of their other young players, and can still be a quality piece for them for the next few years. Another potential option is the likes of the Washington Wizards, who could look to acquire a better second piece. It could be the Lakers trying to get a different piece and the Washington Wizards trying to acquire a different piece in some type of trade for Kyle Kuzma and Davis Bertans. What pieces get added along either way, you could argue either side, but Davis Bertans, of course, is a very good three-point shooter, though definitely a worse three-point shooting season this year for him than he did the year before when he earned his very big contract. But the Lakers could definitely do with a good spacing four, and then Washington can add a different piece that might fit a bit better alongside Bradley Beal and Russell Westbrook. One of the more interesting options for me is a trade with the Indiana Pacers that would see Miles Turner potentially go to the Los Angeles Lakers. I think having a very good shot-blocking center alongside Anthony Davis would be very interesting. It gives them very good floor spacing as Miles Turner can shoot the three. It allows AD to play a little bit more inside, which I think is beneficial for his game. I think it's where he's best. And this would just make the Lakers an even better defense, if that's even possible. You have one of the best rim protectors in the league in AD, one of the best rim protectors in Miles Turner. You would have to give up probably the likes of Kuzma, your first round pick this year, a second round pick, and then whether that's Montrezl Harrell who gets shipped, whether that's KCP, some type of value in return as well, along with Kuzma, something along those lines. Maybe it won't require a player, but something in and along those lines. You can argue the value of how those will go. But there's been a lot of talks for about 3 years in a row now that Miles Turner could get dealt from the Indiana Pacers. If I was Indiana or an Indiana fan, I would advocate not for him to be traded. But it seems like he may be traded again this summer, so this is something to look out for if you're an LA Lakers fan. One of the more interesting rumors I've seen, and one that I definitely don't expect will actually happen, is Colin Sexton, who very well could be traded this summer, especially if Cleveland land in the top four and draft another guard. They're going to have Okoro, who's a 2/3, Sexton, Garland, and whoever they add. And Sexton seems to be the one that Cleveland are most likely going to get rid of. They have to pay him first. He's the least pass-first guard of the two of Sexton and Garland. And so it looks like Sexton could be the way that they move. However, I don't think the Lakers are going to be interested in bringing in someone that isn't a veteran that can be consistent, who can play off of the ball. Sexton is not an off-the-ball player at all. He is very much ball-dominant, which has caused some rifts in Cleveland. And so I don't think Colin Sexton is going to be moved to the Lakers, but nonetheless, it is something that has been talked about in a couple of some potential trades. The one I'm looking at here currently is Kuzma, Talen Horton-Tucker, a first-round pick for Larry Nance and Colin Sexton. I don't think that's very likely, but I think we could definitely see a Kuzma and THT package going somewhere and a sign-and-trade with THT as he is an RFA. I think it's likely we see Colin Sexton traded too, as I've talked about in a previous video, if you want to check that out. But that being said, that is some potential trade destinations for Kyle Kuzma. I wouldn't be surprised at all if Kyle Kuzma does get traded this summer. I think they definitely will want to improve on their third option alongside LeBron and AD, someone more consistent and probably someone better, especially if they don't bring back Dennis Schroeder, and then they're really going to want someone to up that position. And Kyle Kuzma is probably the most obvious piece for them to trade, along with THT. Potentially sweeten the deal, and whoever they draft with that first round pick this summer. That being said, if you guys did enjoy this video, feel free to leave a like and subscribe to the channel if you are new. Hope you have a great rest of your day, and I will see you guys in the next one.